at which we considered best represented the task at hand was the ad regarding the branch in San Pedro. I think that was a better ad this morning.
The reason for our loss was that, I guess it was just sloppy planning. I think we just went in the challenge overconfident.
When I lost the challenge, I'm like, again, just, this is just not your days, like really.
I trust not Judith, I don't trust Kenny, don't trust Jaime, I don't trust Kim. I don't trust anyone in this competition because at the end of the day, there's only one that will be the next apprentice. And that's who I want to be.
Apprentices, welcome to Doublehead Cabbage. This is where we'll split up the teams and do our third challenge. The first team will be Judith, Kenny, and Salvino.
And the next team will be Kim, Jaime, and Steven.
As for team captains, we've chosen the ladies to be team captains for today.
So Judith and Kim, you're the new captains.
Let's take a walk down to the river.
The Ritamaya River Challenge has become a Belizean tradition and the Belize Bank has been a long integral part of the race. The Belize Bank Bulldogs team has won several times, including the past 2 years consecutively. For this challenge, you will join on in the tradition that is the Ritamaya.
You will be provided each with a stall here at Doublehead Cabbage, which is the second stop for the River Challenge. Each team decides what product they will offer for sale to the onlookers and participants that will crowd the river banks on the race day.
Here's a chance to highlight your selling and planning skills. The team with the largest net profit is the winner of the challenge. Good luck.
We have some restrictions, soft drink, beer, and liquors.
You will be provided with $800 to fund your purchases. The cutoff time is 2:30 p.m. on Saturday, and eliminations follows at 5:30 p.m.
Usually they, like, you know, like game meat. You know what game meat, right?
Yeah, like deer.
Yeah, deer and...
I get that.
Huh?
Okay, I got that.
Yeah, please, we sell that.
Something like something fresh, something like the juices. Mm-hmm. Maybe fruit juice, we could have like lime, we could have like maybe blueberry, mango, you know, stuff like that.
I think we should keep it simple, like chips and dip and Gatorade and juices, things like that, which we know can sell really fast.
Yeah. We could choose a product that is very delicious.
Exactly.
So, so that customers will get attracted and come more in our booth.
Alright guys, these are the two stalls that we have gotten for you guys. I'll allow Miss Candice to flip, representing that team. If she gets a heads, you pick the stall you want. If she gets a tail, you guys pick. Alright, so she has chosen that stall. You guys get this one.
So we need to have a list of stuff what we need coming in, right? Bristol board, highlighting exactly so people can know what we actually to sell. So we got a Bristol board.
Foods would actually sell. Chips and dip and all that, it's good, it's a good idea. I like it, I like it. And I would go with it if that's your decision. However, you will be competing with people that actually want to have something to fill them.
I feel that by being a leader, I have more pressure on me to make the right choices.
I believe that she has certain qualities of being exceptional, you know.
You'd want snacks, you'd want, how about towels?
No.
I think Kim could do way better as a group leader. Even, I thought that she would be talking more when she was chosen as group leader, but she still seems to just be on the side, watching everybody else.
I don't know if we could find coconut. We actually have the coconut water and then give them the coconut, the big coconut.
The overall feeling about my teammates, I feel like I have a good team. I have two great guys.
I guess now that I'm not the leader and the competition, I mean, the challenge is something different, something that I like, selling stuff, making money. That's what I'm known for.
Some snacks, nachos, ice, and whistles. Yeah. That's a good idea. I think we should run with that.
We don't have coconut corn tortilla, we have happy cow cheese, we have ground meat sausage, bananas, coconuts.
We need a foam board.
Foam board.
Make the sign.
Okay, well, we have everything that we will buy tomorrow.
And that is?
Everything for the snacks, the ice, the dip.
How much tortillas, how much?
Tortillas?
Yeah, for the dip. Cheese and more.
I noticed a lot of Steven's attitudes. He's very, I'd say he's overconfident, and well, I love challenges, so I'm not annoyed by his overconfidence and pompousness. I kind of just, it just makes me, you know, want to do better. But some of the other people find him really annoying.
I have the utmost confidence in myself to draw the attention to our boot. I'm just hoping that Jaime and Kim will break out of their shell and allow us to win this challenge.
I definitely have been taking Steven and Jaime's ideas into consideration.
What about the ice cream? Are we selling that?
No.
Salvino, I really want him to shine and just to open up. You know, I really want him to just say something, and he just...
Working with Judith is good. She always thinks beyond what we should do and well organized.
All right, but then you could make the 150 muffins, right?
But I mean, I'm not going into the challenge as I want to take over everything. I just want to win, so I'll do whatever it takes.
Okay, guys, we need a group name. And so I'm in the thing, I had Riverside, but we need Riverside something.
How about Riverside Bunkers?
I would go with that. That's a good name, because since we will deal with money, and we will make profit out of it, so it's a good name. I like it, Riverside Bunkers.
Okay. Riverside Bunkers it is.
Side. All right, guys, you have 4 hours to do all your shopping, so you have until 1:30 today.
I'm actually like the idea of ceviche, but ceviche again.
Well,
people are hot out thinking. You think people are want fun? No, I thought about like money one fun, but that's like me and myself.
The hero is not here.
$3.95. $10. Hot dog bread, by the way.
Decision, Kim. Do you want
no
to say?
Coffee.
You don't want to do coffee? Alright.
Why not?
Well then, if there's any way that you could think of something that will sell or profit us for $115, that'd be really good.
Today I was not that strong of a personality because I don't want to seem like the person that is leading. Kim is not that strong of a personality, and if I come off as a strong personality in this challenge, I will see him as a leader, and that will be me not playing my part as a teammate. So I had to hold back all that I could. The only part that I could not hold back was the fact that she just did not want to have a lunch menu because she felt that it was too complex.
People now eat chips and dip for lunch.
Steven wanted us to sell garnaches, but the profit will be very low if we sell garnaches. We will have to sell about 100 just to make $33 profit.
To sell chips and dip for $1.50, and these are so shallow, people will consider that as being something that you're getting scammed.
Get another one.
So where's the next stop?
Stationery house, then La Popular, for get fresh bread.
Let's get time when I take the bottom and then
it's not fine.
We need all of that.
Kenny.
Alright.
I have to move a little faster, man.
She was still not talkative enough. She really didn't come up with new ideas herself. It was basically just me and Steven, you know, like just coming up with everything, and then she says like, okay, yes or no.
Do you find that like less than an hour?
Beef. What beef?
You need to sell nachos with beef?
No.
Okay.
To be more in the forefront, I have been more vocal. Well, I have been more vocal about what I think is a bad idea, what I think is a good idea.
But how we are fixing to have places for the food, we can't go there and sell spoiled food to people.
You want to store it before you carry it. You want to eat it before you carry it. Out there, you could store it in the container and it'll last more than 5 hours.
Give me an idea.
Well, actually, I set it up like this, then our name on this, then put some graphic design right there.
Mm-hmm. And then you click it up, make it stand, go in there like that.
Yeah. I don't know if
you're no, like no, she shared in the middle.
I just said yes.
Okay.
Because
I know when I walk up, look at the apartment about anything.
Yeah,
no, anyways.
Book.
Can I? Is there any way that I could maybe purchase these from you?
Huh?
If I could just purchase these from you.
He said that he could make the syrup for us for $25 each. The red and the orange is the natural flavor that they always use.
Orange and red one, right?
Yeah.
Once I want something to get done, I will get it done.
Well, rent your drum to part of it for tomorrow.
Alright.
I was gonna ask you if I could like hire you because you are way better player than me.
Alright. How much you could sell me? We want 8 gallons of juice. 4 orange juice, 4 fruit punch.
Okay.
All right.
And you want the orange?
That I mean, that's the thing. Hurry up, beef. Uh-huh. We're up on budget, right? And say if we get the all 8 gallon of the juices, then all of them have still be for 10, or if we get them like
5.
Mm-hmm. So how much are gallons for the fruit punch?
I
think she said no to all the ideas we had because she just didn't want to do any work. It's like, I mean, we could have made a lot of profit by selling some cooked food, and it was possible, but she didn't want to do it because I guess she's not confident in her cooking skills or preparation skills. I don't know what it is.
I don't think he's that confident anymore, and I feel like he needs to stop talking about if we lose or if we, this one is going to, that I am going to be eliminated if we lose. I just think he's different.
Tomorrow I will put off the best sales prep and entertainment for the people so that they could buy from us, and I will do whatever it takes for us to win.
I still need to make a call so that maybe I could just hire someone to play it for me. Because I could play it, but I just like someone better.
So if we're at 5 and 6 o'clock. Great. Thanks so much. So much. That big help.
We really appreciate it.
You guys give the skunk for the bread? Like, no. Okay. Just trying. Just doesn't hurt to try. Everything's set?
Yes,
everything's set.
Set.
Let's sign together.
And just
deal with any small food stuff we need to do before, and then pick up the stuff that morning.
Best thing we should do when we get home is make an agenda what all we gonna do for tomorrow.
Yeah.
The thing that I'm most worried about tomorrow is the fact that both Jaime and Kim just don't have the personality of connecting with people easily.
Well, I am as prepared as I can be.
I've sold things before. You know, I can and try to be interesting. I'll have to practice talking louder tomorrow.
This will be one of the secret weapons of the profiteers. Go and buy from the river shop.
When you get there, of course we have set up the booth, we have put the tablecloths, set up the table, we sign.
Blow balloons.
Coke up have to go as quick as possible so in a cool out, right?
Me yesterday, Steven was saying that if we lose, it's my fault because I didn't get enough food. Ben was talking about me all day yesterday to the other group, saying that it's my weird highway and that I chose the wrong food list and all that.
You got everything?
Yeah.
Yeah, the bigger balloons will be better for us to build. Yeah. Yeah, we have like kids whistles and adult whistles that we will be selling so that you could make noise for your team. Chips and dip, ice, so you could cool yourself down. And we have like fresh cut fruit.
Muffins, banana muffins, I have sausage from the stick, hot dog, nachos with the meat.
Come to the River Shack, we got balloons, we got sweets, got everything you want, fruits.
I want the 50 cent one.
You can get three of them for shilling.
Two of them for shilling, and two of them for shilling.
We have fresh juices, Tom Brown and fruit punch. Chips and dips, with and without meat.
How much?
One.
Two regular nachos, and I want sausage on the stick or pork on the stick or whatever it is. And how much sell the juice?
Dollar.
You want juice?
Hey, realize we got fruits, we got pepitas, we got balloons, everything you want. Just make nice for your team. Yo, the River Shack, let's come wrong. And we are never clung wrong.
You can learn our beat too and go on bad. You could play the drums for 1 minute for dollar, just dollar.
If you win it, two bills come in, right? And if you win it, you walk away 20 bills. Yeah, if you come in on the contest.
They have a stall over there where they sell cool coffee, they sell nachos, they sell it with meat, without meat, you have muffin, you have tamarind juice, you have fruit punch, you have hot dog.
We have nice pepitas, 150 a bag, it's very delicious. We have whistles that could make nice for your team. Make nice for your team. Whistles, we got fruit, nice.
I even relinquished my pride as a person to go and talk to total strangers for me to sell as much product as we could.
Cheaper shilling, you know. I will have these bands, that for shilling as well.
Mr. also got a chance to go in a raffle. This nice cake.
This nice cake on display.
How much for your muffin?
$150. Welcome back.
Thank you.
And how much did I?
This one, the dollar, and then with condensed milk, the $150.
So this doesn't look appetizing at all.
Big chocolate cake, right? Big chocolate. Yeah. How much did that mean? These are
$2. $2 with meat at $3.
We've started off strong, sold just about everything. Kenny's out there, hasn't come back as yet. Hopefully, he comes back with some ruffle.
I just need to do that, just approach people, be approachable. And you know, if I got a kid, they'll tell like, yeah, we have things for kids and everything, and I think as well. Use them as a way to supply you.
$2 a chance.
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
Support.
Lopez, the next apprentice.
Can you turn on the Belize Apprentice?
Help my group win. I'm an author from UB as well, the Belize City Campus. And I'm supporting, even though I'm Belize Bank, I'm supporting the UB team all the way.
Oh, you want to channel dance? If you want everybody by a chance, let's go.
Is that by a chance?
Yeah.
All right, yes.
All right, go.
One step out to the left, you power to the left. One step power to the right, you step out to the right.
Power to the left! Power to the right! Power to the left!
I really, thank you very much, you really appreciate it, right?
We're going.
We will support your cause as long as you support our cause. Our cause is that you have to do a paddle dance.
A paddle dance.
If all of us are back.
No, that's a little bit for all of we buy, man.
This is the point in your hand. And when you want to do the samba left, you do the samba with the original. So when I say paddle to the left, you paddle to the left. You see?
Paddle to the right! Paddle to the left!
How much are muffin?
150.
Where is the banana muffin?
How you know?
You and the bad over there want 2-1 win, right? No, I forgot tie.
No. Thank you. What's your chip sandwich?
We got $2 with Alright, without
$2. I feel very very tired right now because, you know, I had to get out of my skin and I had to expend a lot of energy to, you know, sell everything that I sold. I had to basically approach everybody and tell them if they want to buy something, and, you know, some people weren't so kind, but, you know, I still sold. Somebody ordered 6 of these snow cones, so I have to send it to them.
Good morning. Support the worded cause, please. Banana muffin, 150. Support the worthy cause, banana muffin for a dessert. Some delicious muffins, support the worthy cause. Banana muffin, 150.
With a win, when it comes to the competition, so as long as we're there, head that way, without even making a profit, I feel confident as long as we win, no?
Crunch time, 1.5 left. So far, that seems to be going is the chips and dip, the juice, the tamarind juice. We finished like 2 of the gallons already. The sausages also seem to not really have moved yet, but I guess when the crunch hour comes in, the major thing we sell right now is the raffle. Your name?
Jimmy Valdez.
24.
All right.
You know, we even play the drums if the kids would want to like learn a little beat or something like that. We're just, you know, like $1 a minute. So it's just for them to learn a little things. We have fresh cut fruit if you want. It's $1 a pack. There's ice that if you want to replenish your, you know, if you're feeling parched. We even have a challenge. If you could drum roll for at least about 5 minutes constantly, we'll give you $20.
$2 for a
I'll take the first bite.
Muffin.
Hey, catch this.
So that you could increase your sales.
I would love that.
You would love it. Yes, we'll make it.
Thank you so much. How are you guys interested in a banana muffin? Oh, thank you. Thank you.
When your crowd come up with the paddle song, we come up with the paddle dance.
Sure.
Paddle dance, just for Tamaya.
Again?
Yes, again.
Paddle to the left.
You even have a drum that could help you with that.
Boy, boy, yeah. Boy, good.
And I could beat the drum too.
Alright.
You advertise or your drums here too?
Yes, and of course. Okay. Of course.
It's a deal, people.
It's a deal.
It's a deal.
You are a man of God. Could you help me, brother?
We actually have started to make profit, which is a plus. So we just need to know that we've made more profit than the other team. Hi, Cavani.
Yes?
You win the cake where you pay the raffle for. So let's come by the booth, yeah, by the apprentice booth for the cake.
Congratulations.
Have a look good.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Buy anything, you will get free food right here. Buy anything, you will get free food right here.
All right, guys, that's it. It's 2:30. That's it. No more selling.
Well, my team did an excellent job. We always cooperate, and we always organize. We don't see no setback in our team.
Well, I'm tired. I'll give you that much. I guess I tried my best, trying to sell everything that I had. Some stuff didn't sell, but I mean the competition out there was stiff. Not only the other team, but the other people out there as well. But I'm pretty confident about the outcome.
We sold out the dip and the ice. Those were the popular items. They went out and they sold the stuff, and I stayed in the booth and sold the stuff. I was a team leader. I thought that they were better at sales than me.
Well, Steven was giving Kim a hard time about it because, you know, he kept saying that Kim was a poor leader, and he's really sorry that he did not take the lead, because he should have taken the lead and we should have sold like cooked food.
Steven told me that, well, basically if we lose, it's my fault, because they wanted to do burgers and they wanted to rent a grill. But I asked Jaime if he ever grilled anything, and he said one time, so I decided that wasn't something good to try. It was difficult working with Steven.
But I did let her know that, you know, it's not always your way or the highway, you know? And I didn't want to seem like the person that you said that I had to hold my strong personality back. It was frustrating for me to do that, but if I went across and I did something and that we probably lost, then that would be bad on my part because I did not allow her to leave. So I did not want that to happen.
Buy anything, you will get free things right here.
Good afternoon, apprentices. How was your day? Tiring? You all got a chance to see the race?
I do.
You did?
Yeah.
This was an exciting challenge from our perspective because it involves a demonstration of your salesmanship. You were divided into two teams, and I believe Judith and Kim, you all led the teams on this occasion. Is that correct?
Yes.
Okay. But could you share with us the process you went through in terms of identifying the products that you trying to sell to the participants in the race and those who went to watch the race?
Our strategy was to cater for people who we believe would be out there wanting food. They're coming out there and they're maybe hungry. Lunch hour is going to be our crush hour. So that was one of the things that we looked at. We also look at camps. We have to know that camps are going to be out there. We're going to be providing, you know, maybe juices, a lot of bread, stuff like that we believe that they would need. But all in all, the idea was to give finger foods, fast foods, something that would attract people and something we know that people would constantly want.
How did you divide up the team in terms of who would be selling, who would approach clients, where would you locate the booth to sell?
Kenny has background in accounting. So off the back, I said he would be the right person to help us do our strategizing in terms of our money and our financing. So he was the one to keep account of the money while we were there. I'm a salesperson, so I was the one outside a lot, going around, bringing in the clients. And what Silvano did was to balance it out at the back of dealing with the grill, dealing with the front, serving people, because it was quick.
Talk about some of the products you all actually sold. What were some of the specific products you all sold?
We sold cold cups. That was for the kids.
What's cold cups? Yeah?
It's Kool-Aid and sugar in a cup, and you just freeze it. It's really easy. Okay. It's cheap, and it's something that kids love. So as we got there, that was the first thing that started to sell a lot. What we also did was a raffle. We raffled a cake. And so that was something that we knew that we could constantly walk around telling people, you know, $2 to a raffle, you know. So that was something that we knew we could always do. A strategy that we came up with at the end was to buy a banana muffin and you receive a cold cup for free. Because the cold cup, we hadn't really lose because it's just Kool-Aid and sugar and water.
What was your most attractive product in terms of sales?
The raffle. I would say the raffle was a huge one.
In terms of the actual purchase of the item, how much money you all spent in all?
In all, we spent $380, I believe. $380 with everything that we got.
And could you explain why it is you didn't spend the entire allocation of the $800 you received?
To spend $800, we need to make $800 and more in order to make a net profit. And to do that, we really had to be selling a lot. When it came to, for us to the budget, spending $800 will really set us back a lot. So I guess I decided on that the less we spend, the better it'll be for us to make a net profit.
We decided on it.
Salvino, what was your role?
My role is like we elaborate more. Sometimes I give ideas.
You don't need to be intimidated, just be cool and say what you need to say.
Thanks. And during the sale for today, I have little experience in sale. And I use that as the best of my ability. And I approach people nicely with a smile and I convince them to buy the muffin and I see it's really work.
Where you all got the muffins? Where you all bought the muffins?
We actually paid Kenny's mom, because she has a restaurant. So we utilized a lot of the stuff that she had. So we paid her, and we also bought the ingredients.
Mr. Marshalleck?
In terms of how you price the products that you sold, how was that done?
The way we did it, in order for us to gain profit, or at least had a projection of what we were going to make, we basically did it in such a way that we were only going to sell chips and dips without the meat. So whatever we sell with the meat is going to be like a bonus on it. So we had a target goal of a profit, not a net profit, but a gross profit. And when the time came for the challenge to end, that is when that people decided to come over and want to buy the most. So I guess at that time, we couldn't utilize that moment.
I like that you were able to read the market, think about how many people are going to be there, and let's not go overboard and end up with too much expenses and capital investment, right? So you looked at return investment. So I commend you for that. Did you have to change pricing on the run?
Probably like in our last 40 minutes. But throughout the other 4 hours or 3 hours, we were same pricing.
Right. So you sort of fire sale at the end.
Yeah. That's when we really pushed.
Was that a successful strategy?
Yes, it actually worked. And at the point we began to say that buy anything, you get a cold cup for free. So I guess that it attracted people.
Salvino, what would your team have done different? And the answer can be nothing.
Catering for people at a large scale and providing variety of products. I think that should attract more customers to our booth. Because we will have lots of items.
Like what?
Like maybe rice and beans.
Did you suggest that to your team?
Well, actually, no, I didn't suggest that.
Kim, it's your time to shine. So you want to take us through how you organize your team, what products you sold, and whether or not you thought you had a very successful day today.
Well, I decided that I would take ideas about the items according to how expensive it would be, because I thought that people wouldn't want to buy something expensive. And so we decided to get ice, snow cones, whistles for the kids, chips and dip, biscuit, sweets, and pepitos, and also sweets. Jaime and Steven, they were better at sales than I was, so I stayed in the booth. Yeah. Steven and Jaime wanted to sell burgers, and they wanted to have a grill and grill chicken and beef, but I decided that that would have been too expensive and people wouldn't want to buy that. And we only had a really short time frame.
How much money you all spent from the allocated 800?
About 423.
423. And that was a deliberate decision, or you just ran out of ideas of stuff to buy?
I decided that I wasn't going to go over 500 because of the short time period to sell everything.
I find ice was a very interesting choice. I mean, you all had an ice cooler, or where you all kept the ice?
We had a cooler.
You had a cooler. A lot of the ice sold?
Yes, a lot of people bought the ice. They liked it, especially the kids.
Someone mentioned to me early on that there was one of the teams bought a drum.
Yeah, we didn't buy a drum, we rented a drum.
You rented a drum.
Yeah, I kind of played a drum a bit. So I said, you know what, we could provide free entertainment. And, you know, people usually watch it because I actually went to the street art festival. And the people that teach me how to play the drums, they actually play the drums and sell products. So I said that that would be an easy way for us to just entertain ourselves and entertain the people so that they could come to the
To attract attention.
Yes.
And you thought it was successful?
At first, yes, it did have a little success, but we were so occupied with trying to sell outside. At the end, it was utilized very well by a person that I knew. At crunch time, we just said that we would be giving out the free fruits, and it actually attracted people. So I guess that it paid for itself, you know, the $20 that we just paid to rent.
So you paid $20 to rent the drum?
Yeah. I told people that they could play on it for a minute for a dollar.
Right.
And also that we had a contest to keep a constant flow on the drum for 5 minutes. If you actually did it for 5 minutes straight, you could win $20.
I'm a bit confused. So if you had 10 players who played the drum for 5 minutes, you'd have to pay them $200?
Yes. So, however, a person did win.
Yeah.
But he was so like nice about it. He said, you know what? What I'll do, I'll just borrow the drum for a bit so that we could play out there. Out by UB,
right?
And he didn't have us like give him the money.
But if he had chosen not to be nice,
well, we'd have lost $20, yes. And after that, when I saw that, I said, you know what, it's not a good idea, so we should stop it. And I told Kim if that's a good idea for us to stop it, and she said yes.
Jaime, you supported the drum playing.
I thought it was gonna work because I couldn't reach 5 minutes. But somebody else was able to.
The guy was very skilled.
Kim, you went along with the idea as well.
I thought the drum contest was a really good idea. Steven and Jaime tried to play the drum for 5 minutes and they couldn't. So I thought it was impossible for anyone to win it.
Very interesting.
When you look at the products that you chose, right? If you're selling like sweets and biscuits and pepitos, I mean, that's very, I mean, those things, you're talking quarters and 50 cents and so you're talking significant volume to sell to make up and to make a profit against $500 worth of, I mean, a lot of small stuff. What was the thought behind that?
Well, the stuff were really cheap. We bought it by the pack at ENR and other stores, so the profit on them was really great. Mm-hmm.
Going into this, did you all sit down and say, like one set of financial projections or just to think your pricing, what you would spend, because this seems, you know, a lot of small stuff to be running around to be trying to sell,
yes.
To try and sell.
We actually did that, me and Jaime did that together. The fact is the pepitas actually only cost $9, it bagged 30. We wanted to sell 100 of those, right? However, we didn't buy enough because like Kim said that we shouldn't spend too much on that because we don't know if how many people would be out there, so we decided not to spend that much. But it wasn't selling fast enough, so we decided to just change the price in the last hour, and me and Jaime actually capitalized greatly on that.
So what product sold the most?
The chips and dip and the snack ones.
Yeah.
Whose idea was that? Shaved ice. Good. But also he had a terrible idea, which is his drumming business, which is, I mean, to me, makes absolutely no sense because, you know, you have to buy a drum for $20. If somebody wins another $20, $40, you know, God forbid somebody else wins again, that's another $50. I don't know how much money you made, but that could have eaten into your profits significantly. But all in all, do you think that drumming business attracted the amount of business that you thought it was going to attract?
I don't think that it did as much as I would have liked it to have done.
Yeah, it was better for marketing than for making profit.
Marketing purposes.
For marketing purposes, when you have 2 hours to sell something, I don't know how much marketing you need, you know, it's to just get out there and get the sales in.
Yeah.
You mentioned, Kim, that your teammates wanted to include some high-priced products. You stopped them. You said no. When you said no, did you get resistance on that? Or you just put your foot down and said no?
I said no, and Steven didn't agree with it, and he was actually, well, the day before, the entire day, he was not happy about it.
He was not happy about getting the...
About not getting the grill and the beef and chicken.
So you're stamping his foot? Stamping and kicking?
Yes.
All right. What would you guys have done differently?
We would not have sold fruits. We would have sold more pepitos. And we would have also sold more ice. We would have also sold cooked food.
Candice, you were there with them during the course of the day. You want to share with us what you saw, whether or not it gels with what I'm hearing here?
One of the products that I think that they could have marketed and packaged better was the fruits. They pre-packaged the fruits at home from the night before, probably the day before. There were a lot of storming in this group. The leader tends to have a passive style. When she told them no, the two team members are really hesitant in listening to her.
Greg, what about your team? What do you thought?
Judith really took charge of the team. Even though she allowed everybody to contribute their ideas, she took the team down the road that she wanted. Kenny pulled his weight.
He contributed a bunch of good ideas. But his main contribution towards the team was really the logistics and organization of the cooking of the end products. My only comment to Kenny would be that you must remember that you're representing Belize Bank, and Belize Bank's one of the main calling cards is superior customer service. There was an incident where a potential customer came up to purchase a sausage on a stick, and the customer wanted it warmed, and Kenny said no. Customer said, you know, it's cold. He said, well, you don't have to buy it. So you ended up losing that customer. The customer went over to the other team and ended up purchasing from the other team. In the interview after, the customer said, you know, Judith's team had the better products, but because of customer service, I went over to the other team.
That's a very good observation.
As far as Salvino, as they said, was the workhorse. He dealt with the grill, and he went out looking for people. But really, when it came down to ideas, he just rode on the coattails of Kenny and Judith.
All in all, from what I've heard, an excellent job. Now, I think it's the moment we've all been waiting for. This was a challenge which required you to outsell your competitor. So the eventual team that wins, the process there is a very simple process. It's simply the team that sold the most or generated the most sales, or alternatively generated a profit and not a loss from the transaction. So let me invite Mr. Maheia. Tell me what your team did.
Their total expenses, $380. Sales, $536, for a profit of $156.
All right, so, Candice?
Total expenses, $423.79. Total sales, $435.80, with a profit of $12.01.
All right, so, I mean, we have a clear, unequivocally leader today. Congratulations to the Riverside Bankers. Congratulations on an excellent job. You have won an adventure tour with Chucker Belize. Enjoy. Judith, you may take your team outside. Kim, you may take your team outside while we discuss how we proceed to the next stage.
I don't go with a tray on my hand and I tell people that you want to buy whistles. I don't do those things. But I relinquish my pride for that because I wanted us to win. And this is the second time you think I wanted to lose?
A charm. I lost two challenges. Thought I was bad luck for a moment. And then I won a challenge as a leader, which feels good.
It was a difficult challenge. I'm tired. The only thing I want to do right now is sleep. But I mean, I won, right? So I'm happy about that.
Well, guys, I would take this opportunity to thank Kono, especially you, Judith. You give us motivation sometimes. Or always, I should say.
I know I'm a little bit rough every now and again. It's just how I roll. I'm a lemon tart. It's how I every now and again. Let's just say that after this, it's on. Game on. Yes, I feel the raft of Hurricane Jones after this.
I did my best. I have no regrets. I did my best. I couldn't do much more than what I did.
We followed through on ideas that we could not capitalize really well on. I take, like I said, the fruit idea was my idea. I made the idea so that we did not have to spend too much money and we could gain some money off it. I guess it was a bad idea.
Well, we had really good ideas and Kim brought, she did not decide to go along with any of them. And well, I kept telling her that I wanted to, sell stuff, but she kept saying no.
That. Yes, you did say that. You did say that. And I think I should tell you that I'm sorry that I didn't go with you as much as I should have. But I don't want to seem like that because people need to lead themselves. I am not a person that will if you lead us to a loss, you're the leader. She had certain ideas, but the only thing that I regret, Kim, as being a team, part of your team, was just that we did not have a lunch menu. And then I had to come with this fruit idea, which I'm disappointed in having.
Why was it that when you guys last night, instead of standing and while cutting your fruit, you could have easily walked over to Kim and said, Kim, this is how I felt. Instead, you guys sat or stood, not must be 3 feet away and talked about the gal. We could have heard everything. We heard everything you guys said. She heard every single word. Keep it real. Yes. Stop to make it seem as if though you guys made to try work together. Because none of them made to try work together. That never made it happen.
Did I come and complain to you today? Did I seem that I didn't want to do what I needed to do today?
I just took it as constructive criticism, and as a leader, Kim should just take it and either have a comeback or step up. She did not deliver.
If I did not apologize, Kim, I apologize now. Okay? Alright? I did my best. I am utterly tired. I don't play drums. I don't go with a tray on my hand and I tell people that you want to buy whistles. I don't do those things. But I relinquish my pride for that. Because I wanted us to win. I don't want you two guys to come here and have to be in this seat. This is the first time you even went into the seat. And this is the second time you think I wanted to lose?
Welcome back.
Thank
you. Kim, you're on the spot. Explain to us what you think went wrong today.
Well, I felt like I failed my team because I didn't come up with better ideas, but I also felt that it was the personalities in the group because Steven, he have a really bad temper. And he was talking about me bad all day. That day because he was mad about the food menu and it's difficult for his ideas to come across because he can't say it in a calm way. And if you say anything and fight with him, it's only going to get worse. So I didn't say anything, and Jaime was a follower. I was in the kitchen making the dip, and they were in the other side of the house, and they were talking about me, and I heard them.
When you say talking about you?
They were saying that I was a bad leader and that I should have had more food on the menu. But when we sat down and we talked about it, it was difficult for them to get across their ideas with Steven, because Steven, he can't stay calm and say things to you. He just have a bad temper. I think that he have a serious problem with a woman leading.
Really? And how you felt when you heard them saying these disparaging things about you?
I felt bad. And in the kitchen, me and Steven almost got into a quarrel. And I told Steven that not to quarrel with me because I'm not into that.
If you had the opportunity to do things your way, what would you have done differently?
I would have thought about another way to deal with Steven. I don't, because we could have came up with better ideas if we were all on the same page with no temper or anything.
Steven, yes, sir. You need to defend yourself.
I could never have a problem with a woman leading. I had to hold back. I had to hold back from leading because I did not want to lead Kim or be somewhat of, we call in the house an Andre, because we don't want to lead anyone.
A what?
An Andre.
It's an interesting concept.
Jaime was adamant and saying, you know, let's do this. Kim said, no. I compromised and I came up with certain ideas that she took to, because I did not want her to feel that I could not listen to her.
Let me hear from Jaime, his interpretation of the events.
I just heard him talking about, you know, Kim, and I didn't really think of it as being sexist. I just thought that he was expressing his sentiment. I kind of felt the same, because, you know, I expected a lot more of Kim, and I really thought that, you know, she could have done a way better job. It's not that I followed Steven's opinions, but you know, I just didn't negate them because I kind of felt the same way. But you know, our leader was, you know, she could have made some better decisions.
Who do you think should go home?
I think our leader should go home. I believe her performance is just not up to standards.
I was always saying that Kim should go home because she just didn't make the correct decisions.
Kim, you think you should go home?
I should not be sent home today because it was because of the personalities in the group that was the reason why we lost the challenge. Yeah. It's difficult for their ideas to come across because Steven has a bad attitude and Jaime is a follower, and we didn't have that group unity.
I would just like to say that I am not a follower.
I think the team lost because you had a couple of bad ideas. Selling fruits in a bag on a hot day and packaging the bag before was a bad idea. By the time you all got to the river bank, it would have been fermenting, it would have been mushy. I don't know who would have been willing to buy those fruits from you guys. The other bad idea, in fact, what I consider to be an atrocious idea, was the idea of the drum. I mean, I can't understand that idea, because for each person who won, you'd have had to pay $20. So you'd have ended up losing 20, 40, 60, who knows? I mean, you could have lost the entire 400 you had in your kitty had that idea been successful. I think that was a horrible idea. In terms of cooking food, I think there's always risk with cooking food, because if the food is undercooked, then you run the risk that, you know, people may suffer from food poisoning, and that would impact your reputation and the reputation of the organization, which is the Belize Bank behind you. I'm hearing two young men trying to throw somebody under the bus. And we're going to therefore have two eliminations today. Jaime and Steven, you will lead the program this evening.
No problem. I'm actually surprised, but it already happened. Like I already said, I already took up for the fruit idea. I was just trying my best to follow the leader.
Well, the chairman said that we're trying to throw Kim under the bus. I just thought that I was just speaking the truth. I wasn't trying to throw her under the bus. I'm just saying that, you know, that's how I felt.
To throw her under the bus, it was as if, like, how is it that I actually wanted to act mean with her? I was just frustrated that we had certain ideas and I didn't even like that. I admitted to them, like I said, the fruit idea, how did I even come up with that?
Yeah, I think Kim definitely played a pity card. I guess I probably could have, you know, tried to defend her, but I was also frustrated and then think about the possibility of losing. I don't think I regret anything from this experience. I mean, it's helped me grow and, I got to meet a lot of great people. Everybody from the bank, Channel 5, and the people in the house. I have no regrets.
Thank you so much for that, man.
Nora Kim, are you on me or you or me? And she eat away. Whoever the team up with me will win.
Law of attraction is creating a thought, focusing on the thought, and then it becomes reality. And then if you work hard enough for it, the world will give it to you as a prize. The law of attraction. And my focus is to win.
It's funny how you can persuade people. It's an interesting talent.
Right? Thank you.
What?
Mission accomplished.
Mission accomplished.